part kind of seems interesting, all, but the next part says, from boyhood to manhood, infant mortality, educational system. It talks about all that too. So I was like, that's kind of interesting. That's what I wanted to read up to there at least. We can put up there another time, but I wanted to read up to there at least. It's a misconception on the street that the Christians are not doing work in the community, and only the Muslims are involved in the neighborhood. Mm. The next time a Muslim tells you to quit practicing that white religion and to follow the original religion of the black man, ask that person the following questions. When did Islam originate? When was the Prophet Muhammad born? Were Muslims ever involved in slavery in Africa? When did it begin? When did Islamic slavery end in Africa? Did Islamic slavery precede Christian slavery? Did Islamic slavery in East Africa continue longer than Christian slavery in West Africa? Does it remain today in Morocco, in Mauritania, somewhere? I would encourage the readers to review the works of Dr. Yosef Ben Jochanan, such as African Origins of Western Religions. Which points out that the major tenets of Judaism, Christianity, and Islam developed in Africa. Prophet Muhammad was not born until 572 AD. I would also recommend that you read the book entitled The Destruction of Black Civilization, in which Chancellor Williams documents the Islamic slavery of East Africa, which preceded Christian slavery in West Africa. Although you would never learn of Islamic slavery when talking to Muslims, they had been involved in slavery. Slavery in East and North Africa began in 700 AD. Did not officially end until 1991. Sheesh. The radical atrocities continued to occur in Africa by Muslim Arabs against black Africans. Many young brothers have been raised in the church by a mother who has managed to keep the family together with much prayer and Jesus. And these boys have seen their mother's strength, which they didn't see in their father, who walked away from the family and left them. They saw her perseverance. They saw their mama scrub floors so that they could go to college. It concerns me to see these sons leave the church and pray five times a day without praying once to their mama's God. Mm. I have two questions to ask these sons. Did Prophet Muhammad die for you? Did he say he was coming back for you? As we prepare ourselves for the next chapter on the state of the African-American male, I am reminded of this very humorous but real story that a gynecologist shared about a Muslim sister in labor for long hours. Finally, with much effort and with a tremendous push, at the point where Reverend Youngblood says, the marrow meets the bone where the heart hurts. She screamed at the top of her lungs, Jesus! She said, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. You're not going to say Jesus. Say, Jesus. She screamed at the top of her lungs, Jesus. Next one, chapter 4. We don't get into that another time, but that's the next one. And that seems like an interesting one. So y'all kind of got in a groove of it too. That's how I would keep reading, but it got more interesting as like a little bit of time went on. So hopefully I can pick back up another time and read some more of it. But I don't like to do the reading for too much, but I kind of want to keep reading that. But I'm gonna just be out. You know what I'm saying? I was just kind of doing ones and twos, so I'm gonna just be out. I don't want to have it too long. That's for the book club kind of thing. So, yeah, I want it.